Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's GTA 5 video, we're going to be talking about 20 insane changes that Rockstar have made in the Diamond Casino and Resort update that you might not have known about. So let's begin with the inside track horse racing. We're going to be talking about the main event today. This is probably the less of the popular options, but did you know that once you bet on the main event horse, you don't have to stay and watch. So you can bet on whatever horse you want in whatever amount or fashion, and then you can go about doing your own thing. You can leave the casino, you can go to other parts of the casino, and when the horse race is over, the game will send you an alert message saying what happened with the horse race. In my case here, you can see that my horse won, and that I was given 40,000 chips. That's so cool. I had always thought you had to stay around and sit at the computer. Turns out that's not the case. You can go bet on it and then leave and do whatever you want. You can even leave the casino too, which is really cool. The second thing we're going to be talking about today is a secret code that you can enter at the Invade and Persuade video game in your apartment. It's actually a little Easter egg that Rockstar added in the game. It's based off the Konami code, which is one of the more popular cheat codes in video games. So on the briefing screen before you start, if you enter up, up, down, down, left, right, and then on Xbox, it's B and then A. On PlayStation, it would be circle and then X. You should hear a little alert tone, and then you will notice that you will be given 99 lives, which is awesome because now it makes it a whole lot easier to play this game. And it also makes it a lot easier to unlock a lot of the t-shirts that are involved for progressing through some of the missions. So if you've been having a hard time playing this game, Invade and Persuade, well, now there's a cheat code that allows you to get a ton of lives. So you will basically never die. In previous videos, we've talked about how you can get kicked out of the casino if you enter areas that are meant for VIPs only. Well, apparently you can get kicked out of the casino if you harass the NPCs too. I saw this video where someone was trying to take a selfie with an NPC, and maybe they were just bumping into them too much, but as they were taking the photos, they literally got thrown out. So I don't know if it was the fact that they were trying to take photos in the casino, or if they were running into the NPCs. I'm not sure, but it's another way in which you can get thrown out. I thought that was pretty funny. Something interesting that Rockstar added for female characters only in this update, they gave them more dancing animations. So if for whatever reason you're ever in your nightclub and you have a female character, well, just know that she's got some more dance animations that were added. Maybe these were left over from the After Hours update that Rockstar decided to add now. I'm not too sure. Seems kind of random, but it was only for the female characters, which I found to be kind of weird too. Moving on, the Lost Slam Van, the rarest vehicle in the game that can technically only be won from the Lucky Wheel. Well, some people were actually winning it on PC, but they weren't unlocking it. Well, it turns out that Rockstar made an error and that the PC version of the Lost Slam Van was broken for a long time. Well, that has actually now been fixed. Rockstar did a background update, a hot fix, and now if you were lucky enough to win the Lost Slam Van from the Lucky Wheel, you'll be able to store it no problem on all consoles and systems, which is great news. Now, speaking of the Lucky Wheel, we need to talk about why some vehicles don't appear on there from a technical side. And we actually get this from Rockstar insider Tez Funds 2. So he said this. He states, "Turns out Rockstar can't add all the vehicles because the podium area is limited and Rockstar have to adjust the location of each vehicle that will appear there, unlike the mystery vehicle list, which could feature more vehicles in the future." So that's kind of obvious, but it also might explain why some of the bigger cars and even trucks and SUVs might not be on the list because, number one, Rockstar has to individually place them, but number two, obviously they're limited given the size of the podium. You couldn't have a vehicle that's like hanging off the edge and is like beyond the ropes. That would just look very, very awkward. So as you guys know, Rockstar added some new artwork this week inside the casino store, and with that came a handful of new Easter eggs, which I found to be pretty cool. This first one right here, which is called Vices, you might think to yourself, why did Rockstar call it that? Well, the lady in the photo is actually the iconic Vice City girl, who was featured on the in-game artwork and the box art for the game when it was released. She can be seen in a handful of other areas in GTA 5, but now you can sort of immortalize her inside of your penthouse, which is really cool. And this artwork right here, which is one of the two-sided displays, that guy in the bottom right-hand corner who looks like he's laying on a bed of money, this is the guy from the Ill-Gotten Gains Part 1 artwork who's laying on a bed of cash. Again, I found that to be pretty cool. Just some quirky little Easter eggs that Rockstar decided to throw in there. That's honestly my favorite part of the artwork, is checking out like what little Easter eggs I can notice in them. So that's pretty cool, and I can't wait till the next batch of art for more potential Easter eggs to show up. Moving on though, as you know, Rockstar disabled passive mode in all weaponized vehicles. However, one weaponized vehicle seems to have slipped through the cracks, and that is the jetpack and the thruster. So if you do have the thruster and are using it for whatever reason, just know that it's the one weaponized vehicle in the game that can actually go in passive mode. I guess Rockstar just forgot about it, or they figured it was a bad enough weaponized vehicle that they really didn't care about not having it. So either way, that's kind of interesting. In previous videos, you've heard me talk about how there's going to be new time trials added in this update. Well, this has actually been found by Wildbrick142 on the GTA forum site, and we now know the names of the new time trials and also like the in-game thumbnails that you'll see if you hover over them. So the new time trials are Elysian Island, Galileo Park, Stab City, Vinewood Hills, Grove Street, LSIA 2, Pillbox Hill, Elysian Island 2, Lake Vinewood Estates, and El Burrow Heights. So I don't know when these new time trials are going to be implemented. They're not in the game right now, but they are going to be new drip feed time trials. And remember, there's going to be RC Bandito time trials too. There's 10 of them. Construction Site 1, Cypress Flats, Cemetery, La Fuente Blanca, Little Seal Park, Davis Quartz, Vespucci Beach, Construction Site 2, Vespucci Canals, and Power Station. So again, we're not sure when these are going to be added, but it looks like there is 10 new time trials and 10 RC Bandito time trials that will be added within the next couple of weeks or within the next couple of months. Now, in my opinion, one of the more disappointing things about the casino update is the fact that the roof terrace, number one, doesn't really have a lot to do. And number two, it's exposed to like the wild where people can, you know, shoot you and you can pull out your own guns. And one of the more things that's disappointing about that is the bar on the outside is not open. So I thought it was closed when I visited the first time because I came out at night. And I was like, okay, that makes sense. The bar outside is closed at night. But no, this bar is closed all the time. It's like, why doesn't it function like the bar in our penthouse? Why doesn't it function like the bar in the casino? Like, it just would have been another opportunity for Rockstar to make this place feel a little bit more lively, but it just seems kind of bland and stale, and it never opens, which is really unfortunate. Something that's not unfortunate, it does seem as if Rockstar have changed some banned countries, and they actually now allow them to purchase casino chips. So I can't confirm this for sure, but I have seen rumblings that people that live in countries where the casino activities are banned can now still purchase chips to be able to go buy items in the casino store, which would allow them to purchase the new clothing items, accessories, and stuff like that. So if that is the case, that's great news because now you can potentially enjoy more new content. I still personally believe even if you are in a banned country that you should be allowed to at least spin the lucky wheel because there's no gambling on that. It's you don't invest any of your own money other than maybe a membership to the casino. But other than that, winning everything is free. So I don't understand why Rockstar were so finicky with that. Let's talk about some more details regarding the Agatha Baker casino work. These are the things that you have to launch in free roam. So a couple of things I did not know. There are actually in-game rewards for completing a certain amount of missions. So if you complete 5 of these missions, you get $10,000. If you complete 10 of them, you get $20,000. If you complete 25 of them, you get an extra $50,000. And if you complete 50 of them, you get an extra $100,000. That's pretty cool. And apparently there are 2 secret free roam missions that not a lot of people know about. The first actually occurs when you are drunk. So you have to be drunk first before calling Miss Agatha Baker. And it's a mission called Under the Influence, which is an interesting mission. It has you like retrieving a car and avoiding the cops. So kind of cool. And there's another one that apparently involves the Swift Deluxe. Rockstar Insider Test Funds 2 says there is a less than 10% chance to trigger it. So there's 14 common ones, and those are sort of the two rare casino work missions that have been added in this update. Now, I've gotten a few questions about this too regarding the slot machines. As you guys know, or hopefully as you know, there's two ways in which you can activate the slot machine, the spin green button and the sort of lever on the side. A lot of you guys were asking, is there a difference? The answer simply is no. The spin is faster. Like, I don't know how quicker, but it's probably like half a second quicker. So if you are going for speed and you want to just crank out as many spins as possible, hit the green button. Don't do the lever. There's like a little extra animation, and I guess it just takes a little bit longer. That's something you might not have known, though. And last but not least today, if you felt like you've missed out on the Twitch Prime stuff before the update came out, have no fear, you can still join at any time and you'll actually be able to hop right into some pretty cool rewards. Like, for example, on one of my secondary accounts, when I don't have Twitch Prime linked, I get this in-game advertisement that tells me like all the Twitch Prime bonuses I can still get by signing up now, including free money and a whole lot more. So just something to think about right there. If you haven't signed up yet because you either didn't know or you were just too late, well, you still can, and you can still get plenty of benefits as well. But anyways, that right there is all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. 20 insane changes that Rockstar made in the Diamond Casino and Resort update that you might not have known about. As always, I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Do you know of any other hidden features, secret details, tips, or tricks that we didn't discuss in this video? Let us know in the comments down below. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And remember to subscribe if you guys are new or you want to stay up to date on all the latest GTA 5 casino news, info, videos, and more. And ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.